In the previous few videos, we talked about line integrals. In the next few videos, I want to talk about surface integrals. We'll begin with the surface integral of a scalar field. We have some surface in three dimensions. The surface itself is a two-dimensional object. We have a scalar field defined on the surface. The surface integral of the scalar field will be obtained by a Riemann sum, where we break the surface into small surface elements ds. We multiply each element by the average value of the scalar field, say f of r, on that surface element. And then we sum over all of those surface elements. So we'll denote that by the surface integral of f, the scalar field, evaluated at r, integrated over the surface. Okay. So how do we actually compute such an integral? We have to do a parameterization of the surface. To parameterize a surface, we'll parameterize it by parameterization of R. We need two variables, which I'll call U and V, to parameterize. So that will be X, which will be a function of U and V in the I direction, plus Y, which is a function of U and V in the J direction, plus Z, which is a function of U and V in the K direction. From this parameterization of the surface, we construct the surface element, ds, so the area of this small element. We can get that by small variation in r. We use the partials with respect to r, so partial of r with respect to u, and cross it against partial of r with respect to v. This is a vector which represents the area of this small parallelogram. So we take the absolute value of that, and then we'll need a du and dv. So this, using the cross product and the partial derivatives, this term here then is the element of surface area ds. It's the area of a tiny parallelogram that we get when we vary r with respect to u and r with respect to v. Okay. Let's look at a particular case. What happens if z then is a function of x and y? So we specify the surface above the xy plane, given by z as a function of x and y. Here, our parameters then, instead of u and v, our parameters will be x and y. So our r then is going to be equal to x times the unit vector I plus y times the unit vector j plus z, which is a function of x and y, times the unit vector k. So that will locate then a position on the surface. To compute this surface integral, then we need the partial derivatives. So we have the partial derivative of r with respect to x will be the derivative with respect to x will be I. The derivative of y with respect to x is 0, and the partial derivative of z with respect to x will be partial of z with respect to x times k. Similarly, partial of r with respect to y, the derivative of x is 0, derivative of y is 1, so that will give us j, plus partial of z with respect to y times k. Now we want to determine ds, so we need this cross product. So the cross product of partial of r with respect to x, which is a vector, crossed into partial of r with respect to y, is this 3 by 3 determinant, right? It's I, j, and k. partial of R with respect to X. So that would be 1 I plus 0 J plus partial of Z with respect to X, K. And then partial of R with respect to Y is 0 I plus 1 J plus partial of Z with respect to Y. Okay, so what is this? This 3 by 3 determinant. So it's I times a 2 by 2 determinant here. So negative partial of Z with respect to X times I plus J times this 2 by 2 determinant with a negative sign. So it will be minus partial of Z with respect to Y times J plus K times this 2 by 2 determinant, which is 1, so plus K. So that gives us our dr dx cross dr dy. The ds then is the length of this vector times dx dy. So if we put that together, then we have the integral over our surface of f of r ds is going to be a double integral over the area that we're integrating in the xy space. So let me just say integral of A. And then we have our f of r. So r is depends on x, y, and z, right? So we can write x, y, and z here. X, y, and z, which is a function of x and y, right? Times ds. So our ds here is the magnitude of this vector. So it is the square root. So the k component has 1, so it's 1, plus the x component, say, so we square this. So it's partial of z with respect to x squared plus partial of z with respect to y squared from the j component, square root. And then finally, dx dy. Okay? So then this gives us a formula for integrating a scalar field over a surface in the case where the surface is specified by z, which is a function of x and y. So we integrate over x and y. We have our scalar field, which is specified once you know the x and y value. And then we have our ds, which has to be calculated by taking the partial of z with respect to x and the partial of z with respect to y. So let me summarize. I'm defining what it means to take the surface integral of a scalar field. As always, we define it in terms of a Riemann sum. To actually do the integral, we have to somehow parameterize the surface. If we parameterize the surface with two variables, u and v, then we have to have our ds coming from essentially the area of this little parallelogram, which is given in terms of the cross product of the two partials of R and the length of that vector. In the case where we have a surface which is on top of the xy plane, so that the height is parameterized in terms of x and y, then we can derive a formula for this for this surface integral as an integral over dx and dy. I'm Jeff Chasnov. Thanks for watching, and I'll see you in the next video.